What is up, guys? Welcome to another Behind the Curve Reacts. As always, enjoy the kind of content I'm putting out. Feel free to like, comment, subscribe down below, share with your friends, all that good stuff. But today we've got a Patreon request. So my amazing patron, Morty, thank you so much for the patronage, for the request. It means the absolute world to me. But we're going to be taking a look at Shrek the Musical again. This is going to be, I think, the third number from Shrek the Musical that I've reacted to. There was a Freak Flag, which was really big and a lot of fun. There was the Tony performance, Lord Farquaad's song, which was also a really big number, a lot of dancing, awesome choreo. But the two things that those numbers have had in common is that I really didn't get to see a lot of Shrek, which he is played by Brian D'Arcy James of Smash, Something Rotten, Hamilton fame, amazing actor. And I, like the little bit that I saw in the Tony performance, just a couple of lines, was hilarious. But I really want to see like a full number with him. Also, Sutton Foster plays Fiona, which is ridiculous. So normally with these performances, I really like to see like really big numbers, a lot of dancing. But I think I'm ready for like a heartfelt ballad from Shrek, because I know Brian is a great singer and Sutton is, you know, Broadway royalty. So I'm hoping that that's what this is. But the first two have been so much fun and just so neat and like off the wall that I'm sure it's going to be entertaining regardless of what it is. But yeah, this is going to be I Got You Beat. I don't know if I said that earlier or not. But yeah, I'm really excited. So thank you all so much for watching, and let's go ahead and get into it.
Although it must have been nice to have a roof and a cozy bed, which is more than I had when I left home.
You're not actually comparing yourself to what I endured.
I'm just saying you don't corner the market on unhappy childhoods.
There are things you don't know. You know? About me. About how rough I had it.
What, you run out of shampoo a couple of times?
I mean about my life.
In that cushy tower of yours.
Cushy? Are you kidding? I had nothing in that tower. Fighting boredom by the hour. Princess lonely, walking circles. I had only bare essentials, army cot, a hot plate and a chamber pot. And every morning I would boil it. No choice, I had no toilet, just a view of devastation. A one window isolation in my bedroom and very little headroom. 20 years I sat and waited. I'm very dedicated. On the walls, the days were added. Luckily, those walls were padded. So, I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat.
Oh, you think so? That was a sad story, but I've heard better, I'm just saying. A for effort, thanks for playing. Sad to see a princess suffer, but I had it rougher. Like that time a mob with torches burned my britches. See the scorches, they're just whiny. I had a flaming hiney. As I fled, I had to wonder if I were torn asunder. Would an ogre go to heaven? Did I mention I was seven? So, I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah, 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 yeah. I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat.
No warm regards.
No Christmas cards.
And every day
was hell on Earth Day. Away. It was my birthday.
I was sent away on Christmas Eve. Their essentials are being hot. Every morning
Christmas
I would boil it. No choice, I had no toilet.
And
just a view of devastation.
On
one window isolation.
Day.
In my bedroom and very little bedroom. 20
I
years
I sat and
waited.
My dad and mom sent me away.
Away.
think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah. I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah.
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 Yeah. I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Let's see.
Oh my God.
Oh, well, better out than in, I always say.
Oh my God. It's a big step in a relationship. God. Wow. Wow. Okay, so like the burping and farting battle, that might have gotten a little bit too much for me. But everything else was really good. That was very, very well done. It almost reminded me of like that scene in Deadpool where Deadpool and, oh, I forget his girlfriend's name, but they're like comparing who had like the worst childhoods. Like, this was just like a musical version of that, but between Shrek and Fiona. And it was really adorable. And Sutton Foster is just so damn goofy. Like, she's got a great voice. She's a wonderful actress. But she is super duper goofy. And it actually makes me think, like, is there a pro shot of this cast of Shrek? Because that looked pretty damn professionally shot to me. So if that exists, I will have to throw it on my full musical list. Because, yeah, this was essentially everything that I wanted. It was more of a slower, nice, I don't know if heartfelt is the right word, but a nice song, you know, versus just a really quick, big, dancey number. Man, this cast is really good.
Sutton and Brian have such great chemistry. Like, I need to see them in more stuff like that. It was funny, it was a little over the top, it was a little raunchy, but I totally just, I believed that love. Like, that was so damn cute. And like, I have never actually seen Sutton Foster in an entire musical before. I've seen her in performances and I think on TV, but I've never actually seen her like as a lead in a show. And I really think that Shrek the Musical might be the first one. Especially if there is a really nice, awesome pro shot somewhere out there. And those, like, dueling harmonies there were like, they, like, Fiona had her intro, Shrek had his, you know, retort, and then they literally came back and they were singing it at the same time, like, against each other. And then they had that amazing, you know, we're not so different, you and I moment. I was like, oh my God. And then the chorus after that, those harmonies and the looks, like the looks between the two of them with the you, it seemed even more than it needed to be. Because obviously when it's on Broadway, you know, Broadway versus like a movie or TV show, the camera isn't right up in your face. You know, you kind of have to do big grand gestures so everybody can see you. You know, everybody that's 200 yards back. Everybody, you know, knows what's going on. So those tiny little adorable looks from Shrek to Fiona, like, they weren't even like 100% necessary, but just the fact that they did it, it just, the fact that I was watching, you know, cameras that were actually pretty close to them, it just made me believe that love between Shrek and Fiona even more. Oh man, this was so fun. And now essentially I've seen everybody that I can think of. Like that Freak Flag one, I saw pretty much all of the fairy tale creatures. I got Lord Farquaad's big number, and now I've seen Shrek and Fiona, and they're essentially like falling in love number. So I think the only other person that I have yet to see is Donkey. Like I've seen Donkey, but I really haven't heard him like speak or sing or anything like that. So I mean, he's pretty much the last one. But everybody else has been spectacular. Morty, thank you so much for kind of introducing me to Shrek the Musical. Again, like just hearing the name Shrek the Musical, I would assume it's not gonna be very good, and that is exactly why I need to stop judging books based on their covers, because this has been splendid in every way. But yeah, thank you so much, Morty. Thank you all so much for watching. Means the world to me. And I will see you all in a reaction very soon.